this fellow musician's reactions to his pieces as such. What so many of us respect in Alec Wilder was his absolute independence as an artist. For years, Alec wrote music of taste and quality with that personal melodic touch that was all his own, undaunted by musical fashions or fads of the day. And who else has been as devoted to the musician in playing in providing a playable, functional literature for all those instrumental ensembles who most composers generally ignore? It was almost a mission in Alec's life to assuage the thirst for good music of the so-called underdog instrument, much in the manner that composers did in the Baroque era, for example. In short, Alec was the musician's friend and an American original. His death was a great loss to American music. Fortunately, his music lives on. Well, this piece was written for two performers in particular, the tuba player, Barby Phillips, well-known soloist, and John Barrows, the hornist. They both taught at Indiana University in Bloomington. I thought this little tidbit would share a little bit about the intimacy of these people in this piece, that they were all great friends. He was always writing multiple works for these people. Six suites for tuba alone. This is the first of two suites for French horn, tuba, and piano amongst many brass quintets. But a tidbit, the Virtus movement, the fourth movement, is written subtitled For Carol. That is Barby Phillips' wife. They're all great friends, and he always took the beautiful lyrical movements and always subtitled it For Carol. So I hope you enjoy the suite for French horn, tuba, and piano. Thank you.
Thank you.